classes of Triveni Memorial Senior Secondary School. I am Kalpana here, your English teacher. Today we are going to learn a new topic of our English, which is the reported speech. So students, in reported speech we do have two kinds of speeches. The one is known as the direct speech and the another is known as the indirect speech. So basically this kind of reported speech is being used whenever we are talking about some kind of conversation. Right, student? So how to converse, and we are doing that writing that conversation at that particular time. You can write that any kind of conversation in two forms. So one form is known as the direct speech and the another form is known as the indirect speech. So now let's see what is indirect and what is direct speech, students. So the first one is the direct speech. In this speech, the actual words spoken by the speaker have been kept within the inverted comma. So the words, if we are writing the exact the same words as is spoken by the speaker, that kind of writing is known as the direct speech, right? So whenever the actual quotation is being used or actual words are being written in our writing, that is being written in an inverted commas. Let's see, for example, he said to me, "You are my best friend." So he said to me that you are my best friend. This "you are my best friend" are the actual words of the speaker. That's why they are being kept in between the inverted commas, and this kind of speech is known as the direct speech. Right? Next comes is the indirect speech. So what is indirect speech, students? Though indirect speech, the meaning or the sense of the words spoken by speaker are conveyed by some other person. Means the meaning of the speech, whatever is being told or whatever is being said, is remain the same, but the wordings might change. Right? Means the whatever is being said by the person, that are being converted in their own words and that is presented. But the main thing is the meaning of that particular words remains the same. For example, he told me that I was his friend. So you can see in both the sentences, the meaning is same, that he has said that he is my best friend. But here the words are a little bit changed, but the meaning is completely the same. So this is the direct speech and this one is the indirect speech. I hope this is clear, student. What is the difference between direct and indirect? In direct speech, we do use the exact wordings of the speaker, but in indirect speech, we do use little bit changed words, but the meaning and the sense of the sentence remains the same. Right? Now, let's see the different parts of the speeches. So, this is the example. She says to me, "You have helped me a lot." So the words which said that, who has said to whom. So these words, or we can call it like the words before the comma, those group of words are known as the reported verb, and the actual words of the speaker, that is known as the reported speech. So in a reporting verb, they are reported sentences. There are two parts of a sentence. The one is a reporting verb, which tells us about that who has said to whom. And the second part is the reported speech, which tells us whatever is being taught. So the exact saying or the exact words of the speaker are being written in an inverted comma, and that is known as the reported speech. Right? Now comes is the words of the speech kept in the inverted comma are called the reported speech. As I told you, the words which are being kept in the inverted comma, they are known as the reported speech. And the words outside the inverted comma, that is the reporting verb, she said to me, has three parts. And this part, which tells us about who has said to whom, and which are outside the inverted comma, these words are known as the reporting verb. That is the same which I have told you also. So in this reporting verb, there are three parts, students. First is the subject, like she. And second one is the verb, that is said to. And the object is the me. So there are three parts in this reporting verb, students. One is the subject, who has taught something. Second is the verb, which tells us about that what is being taught. And third one is the me, that is the object in the reporting verb. Right? So now, students, the reporting verb, direct speech can be converted into the indirect speech, and indirect speech can be converted into the direct speech. For that, we need to learn some rules. So let's see that rules basically. So here are general rules for changing the direct speech into the indirect speech. So the first rule is changing in the pronoun. So first of all, we change the pronoun. Let's see how to change them. While converting the reported speech into the indirect speech, the pronoun within the inverted commas change as per the following method. So students, as we have seen that whenever we are changing the reporting speech, the first of all is the pronoun, the subject of that sentence. So the pronoun, how can we change? So in pronouns we do have three persons, first person, second person and the third person. So accordingly we will do the changes. So if the first person pronoun I, we, me, are, me, us are changed according to the subject of the reporting verb. So if there is a first person pronoun in case of reporting speech student, then it would be changed as per the subject of the reporting verb. For example, student, let's see this sentence. This is the reporting verb and this is the reported speech. So this is the subject. So if the subject is the first person pronoun, this first person pronoun will change according to the subject of the reporting verb. Okay. And second is, if this first the subject of the reporting speech is the second person, then it will be changed according to the object of the reporting verb. Got it, everyone? I'm repeating. If the subject of a reported speech is first person pronoun, then it will be changed according to the subject of the reporting verb. And if the subject of the reported speech is the second person pronoun, then it will be changed according to the object of the reporting verb. Right? Next comes is the third person pronoun. If the subject of the reported speech is a third person pronoun, then it will not be changed. It will remain the same. Right? Now let's see how, let's read it from the content. The first person pronoun I, we, me, are, me, us are changed according to the subject of the reporting verb. I told you the same. The second person pronoun, what are the second person pronouns? These are you and your. These are changed according to the object of the reporting verb, right? Next is the third person pronoun, like third person pronoun he, she, it, they. So all those pronouns are changed according, they do not change, means they remain the same in the reporting speech, right? Next comes is the change in the tense. So once we change the pronoun, then comes is the verb. So how the verb is being changed, how the tense of the verb is being changed in reporting speech students. If the reporting verb is in the present tense or the future tense, the tense of the correct speech does not change. However, the change in the pronoun takes place as per the rules. Right? Means if the reporting verb is in present tense or in the future tense. So what is the reporting verb? I told you just now, students. Let's come back to that slide. So like this. So if this is the reporting verb. So if the reporting verb, this is in present tense or in the future tense, then the tense of the reporting verb will not change. So how will change? Only the pronouns will be changing. No change in the tenses will be made when, if the tense in this is present or the future tense, right? But if it is, what about the past tense, students? But if the tense of the reporting verb is the past tense, we don't change the tense of the reported speech, right? Now, so students, we have learned that in case of present tense or in the future tense, we don't change the tense of the reported speech. Now, the second rule is the tense of the direct speech does not change if the reported speech conveys some general truth or the universal fact. Like, if you are talking about some general truth or some kind of scientific fact or any kind of universal fact, for example, if I say the sun rises in the east, so this is, what is this, student? This is a universal fact. We can't change it, right? So for these kind of sentences, we don't change the tense of the reported speech. So in that case, the tense will remain the same, right? Now comes is in case of past tense, students. When there is the past tense in the reported speech, reported verb, then the tense would be changed. So how this tense would be changed? Let's see that. If the verb of the reported verb is in past tense, so the tenses of the reported speech will be changed as follows. In the direct speech, if the tense is MR, or we can call it as the present continuous tense, so the tense in the indirect speech would be converted into was or were, or we can call it as the past continuous tense. If there is has had, or we can call it as the perfect tense, present perfect, then it would be changed into had, means past perfect tense. Was or, if there is past continuous tense, it would be changed into past perfect continuous tense. Will, shall, future, simple future tense is there, it would be changed into past form, is would and should. May would be changed into might. Can could be changed into could. Simple present means what we have learned from these students. The simple present tense is always changed into simple past. Present continuous is changed into past continuous. Perfect present perfect is changed into past perfect tense. And present perfect continuous tense is being changed into past perfect continuous tense. Means if the tense is in a present tense, jo bhi present tense hai, that similarly their past form would be changed. Right? Secondly, if the tense is in the past, then what will we do? So if the simple past is there, we will convert it into the past perfect tense. And if the past continuous is there, then we will change it into the past perfect continuous tense. Right, students? And if it is in future, we have already told the past form of future tense will be changed. And rest of the sentences, they don't get changed. Got it? So this is all about the tenses, how we change the tenses in the indirect speech. So rest of the rules you will be doing in the second part of this video, student. So for continuing this chapter, you need to go to the second part of this chapter, of this topic, right? So if you like the content, if you like this video, do like, share and subscribe our channel. Thank you.